Brothers and sisters, good morning and welcome home. On behalf of Monsignor Bill Young, our pastor, my name is Father Houston, the parochial vicar, and we welcome you to St. Vincent de Paul Catholic Church, where together we will celebrate the love of God, especially a love that he has allowed us to witness through his servant Jose, that in the gift of his life, he has given us the opportunity to see what true service means. So today, friends, we come, yes, with grieving hearts, but with hearts that are open, hearts that awake, hearts that are alive, to sing the praises of God, to whom all things flow. Please stand and let us turn our attention to the back where we begin our funeral liturgy. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Jose put on the robe, was baptized into Christ. May he now share with him eternal glory. At his baptism, Jose put on the robe of Christ. May he now share with him eternal glory. Here's where I'll need your help.
Our gathering hymn is 691, On Eagle's Wings, in your blue hymnal, On Eagle's Wings.
You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand, and hold you, hold.
Let us pray. O God, who through the ending of present things open up the beginning of things to come, grant, we pray, that the soul of your servant Jose may be led by you to attain the inheritance of eternal redemption through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, please be seated as we listen to the word of God in the first reading.
Thank you. Yes. Okay.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was through an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. But if in the eyes of men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastise a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offering, he took them to himself. In their time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubbles. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Please join.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me. He revives my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Verse number
there
2.
There is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path for the sake of his name. Though I shall walk in the valley of the shadow of death, no evil would I fear, for you are with me. Your crook and your staff will give me comfort.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You have prepared a table before me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil, my cup overflowing.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell for length of days unneeding.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit, who has been given us For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for such a just person. Though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we are still sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, since we are now justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath? Indeed, if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more, once reconciled, will we be saved by his life? Not only that, but we also boast of God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now receive reconciliation, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, please be seated. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person, one might find the courage to die. Friends, it's easier to maybe lay down our life for those whom we love. It's something that the Lord has given us a great joy to do. Notice how you don't even have to be Christian in order to have that kind of mindset. You just got to be human. But even in this humanity, friends, the Lord who made us, the Lord who fashioned us, the Lord who has given us this great gift of courage, gives us all the ability to love. But love comes from him. It doesn't come from ourselves. And if we were to die for a just man, and we also hear how maybe even with courage, we may have the joy or maybe even the desire to even sacrifice ourselves for those who are maybe good. The Lord has given us a wonderful illustration of that in his very self. If you look up at that big old cross behind me, you may see a man that is crucified on that cross. Some may come into the chapel and say, oh my goodness, that's too much. But you know what that is? That is the mark of our salvation. In fact, it is the mark of why we live. You might see a dead man there on that cross, but we know that something spectacular happened 3 days later when he rose from the dead, therefore triumphing over death. Meaning that when we do the same, when we lay down our life for those who are good, we can truly live. Now you might say, well, what about the bad things that I do? What about the bad things that other people do? They certainly can't be good people. Who said that? When the Lord creates, he creates good. That's all he knows how to do. So whenever we kind of start defining and maybe qualifying, oh, that person's bad, that person's this, it's more so us forgetting that that person was good, but their actions are bad. We are good, but sometimes our actions are bad. But you know what? Our actions being bad isn't the only qualifier of who we are. We are rather instruments of God's glory. In fact, we've been given a certain free will. We've been made in the image and likeness of God, not to do bad things, but to select good things. Now, sometimes we fail at that. The Lord isn't calling us to do that. But when we do select him, when we do choose him, when we do do the things that make us live, we find ourselves as instruments, people where we can find security and say, yes, that guy knows God. Does that sound familiar to you? That guy knows God. I visited Jose a few times at Holly Hall, where I had the pleasure and privilege to converse with him. And in my conversation with him, I recognized very quickly that he was a man of great honor. And I didn't know of any of his military background. He didn't care to brag. He didn't seem to lord it over another person. He was just happy of being himself. He already knew who he was. He didn't have to show out. He didn't have to illustrate. He didn't have to broadcast it to this guy that didn't know him at all. It didn't matter. What did matter to him was the love of God. Sometimes that's not the same with us, huh? Sometimes we have to put on different garments to make ourselves feel better. Maybe we have to illustrate and go around with a big old trumpet or cymbals showing of how great we are. Sometimes we don't know, but Jose knew. You could tell in his manner of speech. You could tell of how he thought of God. You could tell of how he prayed to God. And it came from a great place in his heart. Friends, that is sincerity. But guess what? That's not only a gift that Jose was called to have. That's something that we're all called to have. Because nothing in this life qualifies us and shows us how good we are. It's only God. That's why the Lord dies for you and for you and for me, because we are good. And in this goodness, the Lord seeks to work, meaning that if the Lord has chosen us for a certain work, a certain task, we have been privileged to share this task, to work in this task, and convey this message of the good news of what? Not only our salvation, but of eternal life. Brothers and sisters, we have this blueprint, I'd like to call, for eternal life. It's more so people who are knowing that this world that we see, you know, there are some good things in it, but there's a whole lot of bad. But there's a certain longing for more. That longing is, in fact, peace in heaven with God, our Father. How many of you want to pay taxes forever? Let me see a show of hands. You want to pay taxes forever? No? Okay, good. I didn't think so. You seemed like you might be kind of, maybe you do. Okay, good. I don't either. They tax Father Houston heavily for some reason. I don't want to be here forever. This is not my home. Everything that's in my body yearns for a peace that's beyond all telling, yearns for harmony, yearns for a certain goodness that can never be taken away. That just doesn't exist in its fullness here. But we do have great reminders of this goodness of God, be it his servant Jose, the way he touched us, his storytelling, the way he spoke to individuals, inspiring them of the goodness of what it means to be, to have dignity, to have integrity, and serve this nation with courage. We also have, of course, that big crucifix with our Lord and Savior on it. And we also have another great reminder in this Paschal candle. And we call it the Easter candle because it reminds us that we too are called to be lights to the world. Meaning that when we stop seeking earthly pleasures and actually become children of God, realizing who we are, we know that peace and establishing that peace, cultivating that peace, standing up for the poor and for the underserved, and doing all the things that make you seem on earth lowly, are really the things that bring peace to the world. Now, it's hard. It takes a lot of courage. It takes us getting out of our comfort zone. But it's something that the Lord is calling us to embrace. I like to share this analogy at funerals. So if you don't mind indulging this analogy with me, Father Houston likes Porsches. Porsche 911s, to be precise. And if the Lord, who made his servant Houston with such a desire and affinity to cars, the Lord himself knows that maybe a good reward for Houston and all his toil and all his efforts would be this kind of car. So let's say the Lord actually did park a red or black Porsche 911 Turbo S, six-speed manual. Parked it right there in the clergy spot and says, Houston, I know of all that you have done for me, and I would like to reward you with this Porsche. And he gives it to me. Do you know what I will do? I'll pay the tax on that thing and drive it. Give me those keys, Lord. And I'll go up and down I-10. I'll go up and down 45. I go all the way back down to Galveston, take a few shots, a few pictures of that car, and then look at the time and say, whoa, I have the noon mass at St. Vincent de Paul. I got to get back. And when I do get back in 12 minutes from Galveston, Texas, I will park that car and look back at it and say, wow, what a wonderful experience. But that's not going to last for too long, because this person who is built to hope for more will look and say, that's it? All my work, all my toil. Husbands and wives may be able to say the same thing. All my work, all my toil, and you give me this, Lord? That's all I'm worth to you? A $200,000 car? Or a $200,000 bag? Or a Baccarat Rouge 540, the best fragrance in the world? Y'all didn't think I knew about that, huh? Is that all I'm worth to you, Lord? Of course it's not, friends. So we stop looking for earthly treasure, for earthly goodness, and think higher, think better. We tell the ladies often, especially in the school, as they move on towards high school, to not settle. Don't be settling. And we also champion the guys, too, to not settle. But here's a reminder, friends. If it's not through Lewis, then it's through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Do not settle. Open your hearts. Allow true life to flow within you so that you may encounter this living and true God and be the best version of yourselves possible. May the Lord continue to guide us and protect us, and may his wonderful servant make it home to heaven where we will all enjoy true peace, true harmony. Brothers and sisters, please stand. This portion of our Mass is called the Prayers of the Faithful. Right after we reflect on the Word of God, we offer to the Lord from our very hearts prayers on behalf of the whole community, that the Lord may receive these prayers and grant us pardon and help in our need. Let us offer our needs and petitions to God, our Heavenly Father.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayers. For Jose, who is in baptism, was given the pledge of eternal life, that he is now be admitted to the company of the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Jose's family, that the Lord will fill the grief and emptiness in their hearts with the love, peace, and prayerful support of their many friends. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those people who ministered to and took care of Jose, that they will be blessed in abundance with God's love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each of you with whom Jose so generously shared his many gifts, may you all grow in the ability to share your gifts with others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each of us here today, may the memories of Jose live forever in our hearts and minds. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a moment, let us be with our own memories of Jose. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God of all, source of all that is right and just, hear the prayers your servants bring before you. We make known our needs and petitions through Christ our Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, please be seated as we prepare the altar with the offerings.
Our offertory hymn is number 695, You Are Near, 695 in your blue hymnals.
Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Lord, you have searched my heart, and you know when I sit and when I stand. Your hand is upon me, protecting me from death, keeping me from harm. Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Where can I run from your love? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I'd find you there. Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting.
Friends, please stand. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name. For our good and good of all his holy church. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Jose may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Brothers and sisters, please kneel. And if you're not able to, you are more than welcome to have a seat. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our bishop, Italo, his auxiliary, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Jose, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not in our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Brothers and sisters, please kneel or be seated if more comfortable doing so. Friends, we have come to the most sacred part of our time today, where the greatest miracle known to man has occurred, that ordinary bread and ordinary wine has now been consecrated and has now become the body and blood of Christ. It is no joke, but a great delight, a great privilege, a great honor. Therefore, those who are able to partake of this mystery today are those who are Catholic and practicing, and we may receive like we normally do on Sundays. However, if you're Catholic and if you've been away, or if you are practicing of another faith denomination, you're more than welcome to cross your arms like this, and that will allow me to know that you would like to receive a blessing, and it will be my distinct privilege to impart that blessing upon you. And if you would like to remain in your seats during the time of communion, you are more than welcome to do so, that we may all pray together for the sake of his servant, Jose. Let this moment not be a moment of condemnation, but a moment of mutual joy, that we, as we sing the praises of God together, that is the communion that the Lord seeks. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 945, I am the bread of life, number 945.
I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. I am the resurrection. I am the life. If you believe in me, even though you die, you shall live forever, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last Dominus tecum. benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus, fructus ventris, ventris tui, Jesus. Ave Maria. Peccatoribus, ora pro nobis, ora pro nobis, peccatoribus. Nunc et in ora mortis, in ora mortis nostre, in ora mortis nostre, in ora mortis nostre.
Please stand. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Jose, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Jose. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul, receive his soul, and present him to God the Most High. And present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul, receive his soul, and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul, receive his soul, and present him to God the Most High, and present him to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Jose in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Jose in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Jose, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother Jose forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, friends, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Our closing hymn is number 870, Jerusalem, my happy home, number 870.
Jerusalem, my happy home, when shall I with you be? When shall my sorrow have an end? Your joys, when shall I see? Your saints are crowned with glory great. They see God's face to face. They triumph still, they still rejoice in that most holy place. There David stands with harp in hand as master of the choir. 10,000 times would we be blessed who might this music hear. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, God grant that I may see your endless joy and of the same partaker ever.